Somebody, yeah, that's my Maserati going ham. No salami, that's your chick. If I like it, then I'm straight. Boat garden in a club.
Hello, everyone. Hope you're well. Just bringing you a recap of our last war. Fantastic result against Forbidden Junior. This, for me, was the best war we've had in memory. Absolutely everyone performed. And by everyone, I mean everyone bar Flash. Flash was shocking. But anyway, the rest of the team did fantastic and we pulled out a great win. So as usual, I'll give you some of the attacks and let's marvel in our glory. So first one we're going to have a look at is the lovely Karen, who we're mega chuffed for. I'm sure everyone knows, but Karen's been given the all clear on cancer recently, so couldn't be happier. Well done, Karen. Super pleased for you. I think it was 18. Yes, it was. Let's have a look. Using the Idle Plucker Witch Slap. I call it Idle Plucker Witch Slap because Tyke gets wound up. I keep using it, but it's the strongest one I can find, so use it, it works. Jump was very well positioned, otherwise they might have gone all over to here. Good thing about this strat is it works on pretty much any base. If I don't 3-star something with this, I'm disappointed, to be honest. This strat, it's just great. So flexible. You can change it on the fly as well if things go wrong. So I know everyone says try different strats, but I won't. Because it works, so happy days. Right, just speed it up a little bit so you can see it's over. Awesome, Karen. The 6-star master, as we all know. Now again, the good thing about this wall, the 10 or 10's completely performed. If the 9's perform, it gives the 10's the chance to crack at the 10's and the 11's, so 9's, I don't want to disregard them, because it means the 10s don't have to dip, and the 9s crushed it this war as well, to be fair, so well done everyone. Let's have a look at, I think he's number 12, yes he is. Woody was on the last recap and he's done it again, fantastic attack. With the Falcon attack again. But like I said with the Witch Slap, if it works and it's strong and it's getting your results, stick with it. And as you see, when I'm going to show selfishly some of my hits on Tannel 11, because I was so pleased with them and they were well thought out. I know I'm sounding a bit modest here, but and it's the same strat I always use, because I just can't find anything stronger on ground, because as you know, I'm not an airman. As usual, perfect funnel. I like it. Queen or drag him in towards the inferno. Healers on the bowlers. Which I think Woody said this himself. If the healers stay on the bowlers, this strat wrecks. Giant bombs, no problem. Just plow through. Bounces on the Inferno. Perfect.
In control, you know what I'm saying? I slam the door. Boom. When I come into the bedroom, bam, bam. Cause I'm the king of the castle. Nah, nah. Turn me on, turn me loose. Come on. Try to hit it, it's a hassle. Come get some of this. Go forget the innuendo. Play me like the tango. Go, never ever let go. Keep it so loud.
Do it. Bit of an audio glitch there. Sorry about that. He's got all his bowlers still. This is just a great attack. MVP Archer taking these out. I'll speed it up. You can see what. Look how many troops he's got left. It's just craziness. Awesome, buddy. Yet again. Alright, next tunnel 11 is Sally. I think was on number 11. Yes, indeedy. Same strat, but like I said before, if it works. I think this clan, we're actually, someone said they're a CWL clan or a feeder for a clan, so to beat these, it was a great result. Side you come from, they're going to act towards these heroes, and then the Infernos are pretty close as well. Here we go. To be fair, the entrance point, I expected it down here, so just goes to show how good this strat is. As long as the healers run either the bowlers or the Falcons, it seems to do fantastic well. It'd be better that they leave the Queen, to be honest. Well, let's speed up, because we know this the end result is a Super 3. Awesome job, Sally. Well done. Let's have a look at another one. I think it was Kevin this time on 13. Fly, baby, fly. Yes, it was. Now, 3 10v10s is just so impressive. I know I keep going on about it, but it's just, if we can do that each war, we're going to be unstoppable. We've got Nitro up top, so obviously if drop gash, so we're good at turn all 11, so it's all down to the 10s. Perfect funnel. Almost all the bowlers go into the court. And turn around, Queen. Do your job. That's great timing on the hogs as well. Get the Inferno Tower down, fantastic. Queen ability. Nice. Need to worry about that giant bomb. This is a bit of a different strategy. Absolutely wrecked this bass, so credits to Kevin. Let's just speed up a little bit. Awesome job, Kevin. Absolutely awesome, mate. Now, I try not to show my stuff, but these attacks, I'm super proud of these. Let's have a look at the number 5 first. So we're going to have a queen walk for 3. Baby drag around here to stop the queen going round. Bowlers up here in a bit for the funnel, and then everything in through here with a jump there and a jump there. Now, where the queen is, I knew they were going to funnel around here, or a large portion of it. So, both Infernos and the Eagle Tower down, which is the main thing at 10 or 11, so let's watch it. To use the warden a little bit early because this inferno targeted the queen, but all good, all good. Alright, speed this up. Damage has been done. I think I was left with about 10 bowlers at the end of it. Absolutely crushed this base. Get these bad boys. Speed up a bit faster. Now this next hit needed a lot more planning. So I'll just talk through what was going through my mind before. Let's have a look. Bowlers at this end. Minion there was so crucial because I didn't want the bowlers to walk around this way. I was going to drop them here. The plan was to hit them, and then there onto there, but I actually dropped them wrong. So a few more died than I wanted, but it still worked well. Then bowlers were going to here onto here, and then walk around and take these so I could then funnel through here. So it all went fairly well to plan apart from the drop up here, because I wanted most of them alive instead of just the two. This bit went well. I didn't expect them to get the cannon down here, so I was quite happy with this. Save this jump because it was 50-50 for me. Either the troops were going to go here and I was going to jump around here, or they were going to go down here and then I'd have to jump in at the end, and as it turns out they went down. So there was a plan for that. Speed up a little bit. Just looking at the war details, just to let's have a look. So everyone attacked, which was good. All 60 attacks were a win. Look at that, 27 3 stars, 3 2 stars. That's fantastic. And that's obviously from the best attacks. now, this most heroic attack. Chris Sebos is always getting criticised by the awful dictator, so this needs a replay. This was a great stack. The percentage you got on this town, 11. Alright, it's anti 3. He was always going to get at least 1%. Awesome. One jump there to get into everything, and then a jump down here to get extra. But so I'm not criticising, he did fantastically well. ...62% on a Tano 11. Most heroic of heroes. Good job, and like I say, everyone, seriously, that was a fantastic one. What I'll do to end this is just turn the music off and leave you with this note.